Hello everybody and welcome back to Robert's Reviews. Today is Friday, so you know what that means, we get another request. This is requested to me by my buddy Julian, so thank you Julian for requesting. There's a lot of requests, I'm going through them, they're over here on this little sticky note little thing. And if you guys want something to be reviewed by me, drop in the comments down below and I'll give it a look at and I will add it to this here little listy list and we'll get through them. So without further ado, I'm excited to talk about The Social Network. The Social Network was released in 2010. It was written by Aaron Sorkin and directed by David Fincher. So for those of you who don't know or aren't familiar with The Social Network and the movie, I'll give a brief synopsis. So essentially what happens in this movie is we follow the story of how Facebook was created. We get to meet Mark Zuckerberg, we get to meet Eduardo Saverin, who for those of you who don't know is the co-founder of Facebook. And essentially what happens is we learn that technically Mark Zuckerberg stole the idea from someone else. He didn't really steal it, he kind of did. He stole the basic idea, said I'd help you build that, and then realized I could just make it by myself and make it easier and better. And he did, and he called it Facebook. And so it's about not only the creation of Facebook, but also the events following Facebook. Like a huge lawsuit about the fact that it was stolen from other people, and also the falling out between Eduardo and Mark, which is really sad to see on screen. So, I've been meaning to watch this for a long time. It looked fantastic. I've heard so many good things about it. I just haven't had time. And now that it's requested me, I was able to watch it. So thank you, Julian, for requesting it for me. And I'm really excited to talk about it because I thought it was brilliant. I think that the way that the story works is really interesting because they took the beginning. They were like, all right, here's a solid beginning. The middle part was all back and forth between what happened in the past and what happened during the lawsuit. So it was really cool that we got to see that, like, back and forth thing. I was a little unhappy that they did it. I understand why they did it, because then we'd be watching it twice, right? Because we'd be watching it in the beginning when it actually happened, and we'd be watching them talk about it during the lawsuit section of the film. However, I'm really happy with the fact that they decided to go back and forth. I still don't know if that was the right thing to do, because there might have been a better way to film it. However, I couldn't think of one. I literally was sitting there on my bed while I was watching this, like, I don't like that we have to do this non-literally, but I don't see a way that we could not do it non-literally, so linearly. So it's really hard to kind of point out exactly how that should fit, but I'm really happy that they did it. I don't think it's a negative because of the fact that it's kind of difficult to place how to do that. And while the film was fantastic, there were a couple issues with it, like pacing, particularly in the middle of the film, wasn't great. It was a little slow at times, but getting to know the characters was really fun. And while this movie is very, you know, forward with the fact that it's about, you know, Facebook and the creating and stuff like that, but it's also kind of a character drama, particularly when we get to see, you know, Mark and Eduardo and their relationship there. And towards the end, when it falls apart, is so dramatic and intense, it saddens you, particularly because of Andrew Garfield's performance. Andrew Garfield's phenomenal, and just watching him break his heart is just like, it's very depressing. But there are a few issues with it, but like nothing major, other than the fact that it's being slow, and I didn't really like all of the plot. Like, I understand that all of it was semi-important, but, like, then there was that whole relationship thing that I didn't think really mattered. There was that relationship with Andrew Garfield's character and Brenda Song's character that I thought was kind of boring, until the end. Like, it didn't matter, like, that it was a thing until the very end of the relationship, where it was, like, a laugh, you know? I hate jokes for the sake of jokes, and this just kind of felt like a joke to me, and, it kind of annoyed me a little bit that we had to watch that. It is 2 hours long? Yeah, 2 hours long, almost exactly. It could have probably been an hour and a half and have been fine, but I'm not upset with the length of the film, more so than I'm upset with a little bit of the pacing in the middle of it. 2 hours, I think, is okay for a movie of this type of movie. Other movies that are really boring all the way through should not be over an hour and a half. This one, I was okay with sitting through it for 2 hours. I really enjoyed it. Let's talk about some of the acting real quick. So first we'll do Jesse Eisenberg as Mark Zuckerberg. Lots of Bergs. So Mark Zuckerberg is a person we all know, right? Like, he created Facebook. I mean, most of us have seen him, like, not in person probably, but, like, you know, online and stuff. And choosing Jesse Eisenberg was smart because he looks very close to him. It's kind of shocking how close they were, like, in terms of looking. So I was actually kind of impressed with that. But in terms of performance, like, strictly performance, really well done. I think there's nobody that could have done this other than Jesse Eisenberg, I think. And the way that he was able to just talk so fluently and, like, be an asshole, too. Like during the lawyer part, he's such an asshole, and it works so well for him. I like it a lot. I'm really impressed with the work done by Eisenberg there. Overall, a phenomenal performance. I look forward to watching more Jesse Eisenberg movies. I just watched Batman v Superman, which comes out on... My review for that comes out Monday, so look out for that. And he was also in that, and I think he was probably the best part of that film. And I'm really excited to watch more of him. He's not an option for the next slate of series, but he might be for the next slate, so look out for that on Facebook. I will be posting a little thing about what we should expect, what you want to see next in terms of series, so look out for that. Join the Facebook group down the link in the description below. Andrew Garfield as Eduardo Saverin. Now, Andrew Garfield, I think, might have had a better performance than Jesse Eisenberg here. Andrew Garfield was shockingly fresh in this movie. I loved him in this movie. I love him in every movie I've seen him, like, literally everyone, except maybe the Spider-Man movies that he was in. Not that I think they were bad, I just think that he wasn't a phenomenal Peter Parker. He was a good Spider-Man, though. But talking about Social Network, I really enjoyed his performance here. I think just watching him and just him being able to, like, be soft but also stern, you know? Like, he's able to kind of put himself on the line and put his heart on his sleeve and, like, honestly, good performance. Like, I think that I very much was able to connect with the character, you know? Like, with me, I think that I talk outwardly about my feelings, and, like, I think I also am in that boat where, like, I would do anything to help a friend. And really, that's what he does here. Andrew Garfield really just, like, his character, Eduardo, is helping Mark Zuckerberg. He gives him thousands of dollars just because he wants him to be successful. And then he gets none of the credit. And it's like, I feel for that relationship, that character. And so I was really happy with his performance in this movie. Arnie Hammer as Cameron or Tyler Winklevoss. So the Winklevosses are twins, and they are rowboaters at Harvard. And what's interesting about it is he has to play two characters, but they had someone else fill in the from the neck down. So they went to like camp to learn how to be twins, and then they just comped his face out and put another face in. This is a small negative. I totally was able to tell that one was not the same. That was a problem for me, and I was a little upset about it. However, it's not a major negative. It's just I was really, really upset about it because it was almost flawless. Like, next time you watch the movie, it is on Netflix, by the way. If you want to watch it, it's on Netflix. Just, like, watch his face and see how it, like, sometimes, like, move over a little bit in, like, weird spots. It looks not great. But props to them for doing it, you know? Like, even just doing it is insane. And it wasn't the whole movie. It's just, like, some parts of the movie where you just, like, kind of see his face, like, kind of glide around a little bit. Wasn't too bad, but it wasn't great. It was only a couple scenes, so I can't complain too much. But as for the performance, it was fine. Particularly the scene where they go to the headmaster of the college, the president of the college. And I actually really, really, really enjoyed that scene. Let me know what you guys thought about that scene in the comments down below. Justin Timberlake as Sean Parker. So I used to know Justin Timberlake because of his singing, and I like his singing a lot. But then I saw this, and I was like, whoa, he can act. Like, he can actually act. He almost was better than Andrew Garfield. I really enjoyed him in this. I don't know if he's ever acted in anything else, but I kind of am interested to see if he has. And if he has, I'd like to see that. So maybe that'll be something I do in the future. But I really thought Justin Timberlake did really good in this film, particularly considering I didn't think he was going to. Overall, this movie is definitely a must-see watch movie on Netflix. If you're bored and you're on Netflix during quarantine or whatever, go ahead and give us a watch. 2 hours long. Really enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun watching it. I know you guys will too. And I'm going to give this movie an A. Well, that's going to do it for me today. Next week we have Suicide Squad, The Departed, Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. Hopefully Julian will be in that video as well. As of right now, I need to make sure I message him and make sure he's still cool with that. And then Minions, which is technically not part of the Steve Carell series, but I'm doing it on Thursday in replacement of a Steve Carell series because it is in a series that he is in. Like, I want to make sure that I watch Minions before I watch Despicable Me 3, which will probably be in March, I think. And to round out the week, we have The Queen's Gambit, which is a request that I actually filmed like 4 weeks ago because I did not intend to watch all 9 hours in like a day, but I did. So make sure you guys watch that one because it's a lot of fun. But that's going to do it for me today. As always, keep watching movies and television, stay educated, and I'll see you guys in the next video.